As Bob's car had a computer problem and was at the garage, we needed to call a taxi to take us to the start of our trail up to Piccolo Sasso del Putia. After what seemed like a million turns, we arrived at the parking, situated at around 1,800 metres.
Hey, another beautiful day in the Dolomites, and after yesterday's weather, which rained all day, we are ready to go up this new mountain.
Just here behind us, voilà, there are two summits, small and big one, so it's all right. And the place is really beautiful. You can see here behind.
And I think they had snow last night.
It's a fresh snow, like 1 centimeter, so it should be all right.
The landscape was impressive, covered by the freshly fallen snow.
Beautiful fresh snow.
We were very happy to be able to follow some old footprints left by the hikers a few days ago.
But behind us is magnificent view of the Alps, the real Alps. It's not the Dolomites anymore. But the place is just incredible.
Gorgeous.
It's like with the fresh snow, it makes the landscape completely different. And here behind us is a beautiful
waterfall.
What?
With little ice.
Yeah.
Amazing.
It's something magical.
Oh. But it was not too long before the snow started to get quite deep. We were glad to have our gaiters on. We just wish we had snowshoes.
So now we will turn left. And behind us is a beautiful view, of course. And on this side, we go to this summit. Be careful. We are still alive.
Yay!
50 minutes. It's all right.
Well, we saw a few different tracks coming up here, some going in a different direction, and we think we're on the right one for where we want to go, because there's no indications.
We arrived to the next signpost, and you can see here, Fork de Putia, 40 minutes. Well, it will take like 2-3 hours at least.
The track is not as good as it was, because there are less footprints. From now on, the snow is mostly up to our thighs, which made it pretty hard going.
We go ahead. I think that now we will arrive to the flat part, which will be easier to walk. How it's going, Ka?
Yeah, it's great. Love it.
The snow is a bit deep, huh?
Yeah, but it's okay.
Okay.
I've got trousers on.
Good. Well, we arrive soon to the pass. And after, I hope that the snow will be harder and we can go faster. The snow was so bloody deep, huh?
It's very deep.
Wow, hope that now it will be better. If after we have the same snow, we can forget the summit. It's the pass. So like 20 meters and we will see how is the snow after.
We arrived to Forcella di Putia pass, called also Peitler Scharte, situated at 2,357 meters.
Oh, beautiful Dolomite.
but the snow is so deep that it is not possible for us to reach it directly. We have to make a detour from the side. The pass is a very nice panoramic point and an important crossroad from which different routes depart. We are here in Messner's birthplace and where he spent his early years growing up. One of the paths arriving here is called Günther Messner Steig, named after his brother who was lost on Nanga Parbat. It's one of the most beautiful hikes in this area, which we took 2 days later. It's a long loop, alternating easygoing paths, steep crests and via ferrata passages. In the late season, it can be covered by snow. We decided to stop here for a few minutes to eat and do some filming with the drone. As usual, when we open our sandwiches, our friends, the blackbirds, swoop in to share them with us.
I just noticed some goats on a large rock in the distance. I rushed to film them with my drone. It's a fantastic and unforgettable sight.
For those of you who will appreciate the video, please like it and subscribe to our channel. We are quite confident for the future as we see fresh footprints in the snow. We already imagine ourselves following them to the top easily, but suddenly they stop. We've just understood it's hot and there are traces of snowfall. We think people are afraid of it and decided to return. We continue.
It's amazing.
Where all those people have gone.
We are protected from the wind. It's very calm and silent. We feel like we are in a different world. Maybe on Enceladus, the snowy moon of Saturn.
Where are we going to go?
Oh, here, left, right, left. You see the zigzag. Or we can try to go just straight also.
Where is the sun?
I think behind.
We see that the route zigzags in the deep snow going up. As we are already exhausted, we decide to take the shortest direction to get to the summit. We hope that the snow diminishes as we go higher. But it doesn't. Maybe we will establish a new route to the summit. Some minutes after, we are following a new route. Unexpectedly, the clouds come rolling in. Once again, our world has changed, a totally different atmosphere.
Ah, oh, we're nearly there. It's been a struggle, a challenge.
The terrain becomes steeper and steeper. We decide to attach ourselves together with the rope. Karen feels more confident this way. Some minutes later, Karen puts the crampons on. I continue without. Hello, Ka, what you say? you have a red cheek.
So have you.
Oh?
Ah, oh, and a runny nose.
Well, it's great. We are, I think, near to the summit, even if it's not a real summit. You know, we cannot see too much, so well, hope that we are near the summit. The view is beautiful over there. The Karen is still there, carrying on.
You
are not waiting for me. We are together.
Several times we have the impression that the peak above us is the summit, but alas, it isn't. We have to continue.
Anyway, it will be our summit for today because it's late. Last bloody meters.
We got there.
Yeah. Oh, Peter.
Yay.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah. Oh, bloody hell.
Look snow.
Voilà.
Beautiful mountain.
We've done it. Ah, come on. Ah, come on. You last summit, it was only not stuck.
Wow. Voilà. Oh, wow. It's not been easy.
Voilà.
Hey, we did it. We did it. Yay.
We wanted to take some shots with the drone, but typically it doesn't work. It's time to go down, as it's already quite late.
It was a great adventure with the summit at the end. We are so proud of ourselves. We could have easily given up, but our sheer determination drove us onwards and upwards. To top it all for us, we established a new route because we couldn't find it on any map. We named it Never Too Late as our quote. We are really tired.
So we have finished the first part, the hardest part. Now we go down. The taxi will wait for us at 7. And the view is magnificent, as we say in English. Niesamowity widok. Dolomites behind us.
It's beautiful. Had a great day.
Bob has called the taxi man and said we will be down in an hour from now, which I think is a little optimistic. But at the end, we were only 5 minutes late. Bob had me running through the deep snow because I was scared to be left on my own in the snowy forest, and I was trying to keep up with him. Thank you for watching. We hope you've enjoyed the video.